is this Bobbi Althoff everyone's talking about? Me personally, I had never heard of her until her interview with Funny Marco.
What do you think about Tupac?
What do I think about him? He's a lovely man.
Are you going to a show today?
Yes. Are you going to his show?
If he had one, I would.
What a lot of people didn't know is, Bobbi already had a huge following on TikTok that she has been growing since 2021. No doubt, since her interview with Funny Marco, her followers has grown more rapidly. Right now, Bobbi has the fastest growing podcast, and people are wondering how she did it. I feel that she simply found her niche, and she ran with it, and I am all here for it. A few days ago, Bobbi was interviewed by Today with Hoda and Jenna. And they asked her to speak about her podcast. Let's hear what she had to say.
Okay, Bobbi,
the fact that you were so calm next to Champagne Poppy, aka Drake, is sending me. Because if I was in a bed next to Drake, I would be freaking out. It's Drake.
Were you nervous or no?
I'm more nervous right now.
You are?
Yeah.
Okay. Definitely. Well, this has been a wild ride for you. Talk to us about this podcast.
I got the idea in April to start a podcast. And I've always kind of done this character, which is just dry humor. And I was like, I'm just going to bring her along for a podcast.
So when you interview these people, you're not Bobbi necessarily.
No, yeah, I'm just like a really dry person.
I mean, that's such an interesting idea. But okay, let's talk about Drake.
Yeah.
How did this interview come about?
And how did you even, like, the DM that he answered back in 50 minutes, what was going through your mind?
So he, I was freaking out when he did.
So you DM'd him. Tell us what happened.
So he saw my video before that with Funny Marco, and he liked it, and then he followed me. And then when I saw he followed me, I was like, I'm gonna ask. And I asked. And
so you just DM'd him and said, want to be on my podcast?
Yeah, I think that's exactly what I said.
I'm sorry.
I feel that though she may have been a little nervous about asking big-time celebrities such as Drake to be interviewed, she knew where she wanted to take her podcast, so she went for it. Her hunger to be great, no doubt, was the motivating force behind it all. And like my mother always says, a closed mouth doesn't get fed. Say for instance, Bobbi did allow fear to stop her from asking Funny Marco to be on her podcast, she wouldn't be where she is today. Like she mentioned in her interview with Today, Drake saw her interview with Funny Marco, he liked it, and started following her. After she saw that he followed her, she went for it, and asked Drake to be on her podcast.
I was like, oh, have you ever heard Kiki Do You Love Me by like Tyga?
Yeah.
You would be like, you would fully be convinced.
Absolutely.
There's no, okay.
There's absolutely.
What's your favorite Tyga song?
Is he married to Kylie Jenner? So the guy that dated him? He dated Kylie Jenner?
Maybe like before like the iPhone or something. Like.
No doubt, her interview with Drake made it easier for her to get other celebrities to be interviewed on her podcast. Since Drake, Bobbi has had rap artists like Armani White, Lil Yachty, and Tyga. But the interview that stood out the most to me is her interview with Mark Cuban. I was very intrigued by the fact that she got a 65-year-old billionaire to sit on a hard floor in a parking garage for almost an hour-long interview. And the fact that she gets all of her guests to feel comfortable just being themselves is very refreshing. I absolutely love Bobby's podcast, and I look forward to seeing where it's going to take her in the near future. Well guys, this is it for this video. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Thank you once again for tuning in. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell notification so that you will be notified when I upload another video.